What up, fan fam? This is Tatiana King Jones, and I'm here at New York Comic Con 2019, and we're here talking with the cast of Resident Alien on Sci-Fi.
Background with a lot of drama-based projects, lots of historical-based projects, and then you have this.
Mm-hmm.
So how jarring or non-jarring was that to kind of be placed in this world?
It was refreshing as hell. There's a freedom to this project that I personally haven't experienced since... Wow, I don't know. I'd have to probably go back to my theater days. This jumped out to me immediately because it was so unique, and I felt like Sheriff Mike was such a underrepresented character for on television. I don't know if there's ever been a black character like him on television. I kind of see him, as I've told other people, I see him as kind of a mashup of Richard Pryor and John Wayne. You know what I mean? So that's the needle I'm trying to thread, you know, with my performance. But that's how I kind of see him, and I think that he's probably one of my favorite characters I've ever been able to portray ever, actually. And we've only done the pilot, but I've read 102 and 103, and there's I like this guy. I like him. He's not always likable, but you know, with other projects that I've been on, I've always tended to be the nice guy, the goody two shoes of sorts. And so to be able to step out of that realm and I don't know, not have any rules regarding how he can be is nice. I enjoy it.
Yeah. Did this project shift your thinking on what sci-fi as a genre is? And also, you have a lot of deep history in sci-fi yourself.
Well, I love sci-fi. I'm a big superhero, you know, nerd, video gamer guy anyway. So, you know, first of all, I think they are aliens. I think we'd be insane to think that there aren't aliens somewhere out there. There's just, mathematically speaking, there's too many possibilities for it to exist. But, you know, I think the thing that keeps us separated is interstellar travel, intergalactic travel, the amount of time that it would take to do this, the speed needed. Do you have the technology to protect your ship when traveling like that? You know, and that may be the only thing that keeps us from being able to connect. Because I think Alpha Centauri, the next closest star, is still like, I don't know. Yeah, it's like 8 or 9 or 10 light years away from here. And that's traveling at 189,000 miles per second. You know, which we can't reach those speeds. So it'd be impossible for humans to make it to another star unless you can create something that moves faster than the speed of light, which we don't know, and or can create a wormhole or something that allows you to jump from one side to the other and not have to traverse that expansive space. But I will say this, if aliens do come here, we're fucked. Because that means they've mastered all of that. That means that they have an understanding of technology that is far beyond all of ours. And no one ever shows up on your doorstep to give you a better life. You know what I mean? So if they do come, yeah, we're done. It's over. Thank God there's only one Harry.
So
for now.